Welcome to this course on computational mathematics with Sage Math. In this particular video, I am going to explain two things. First, a very brief introduction to Python. And second, installing Python in your system or using it online. So let us get started. What is Python? Python is a general-purpose, high-level, object-oriented programming language. It was conceptualized in the late 1980s by a Dutch programmer, Guido van Rossum. He developed it as a means to solve the problems posed by the ABC programming language. Contrary to popular belief, the inspiration for Python came from BBC's TV show Monty Python's Flying Circus. So it is nothing to do with the snake Python. Since the release of the first version of Python code in 1991, there has been a tremendous development in the utilities of Python. The current version of Python is 3.8.5 as of July 2020. Python is by far one of the most widely used programming languages. It has wide range of applications such as web development, game development, creating desktop applications, scientific computing, symbolic manipulations, and it is one of the highly sought programming languages in machine learning and data analysis. One of the main reasons why this language became a huge success is the readability of its code. Unlike other programming languages such as C, C++, Pascal, etc., Python allows you to use English keywords instead of punctuations. Python requires fewer lines of code to achieve results compared to other programming languages. Due to its popularity, its user-friendly syntax, and being an open-source programming language, Python has a rich and robust standard library maintained by a well-knit global Python community consisting of programming enthusiasts from all over the globe. Python standard library offers a wide range of modules that one can use according to his or her specific needs, and it reduces the hassles of having to write each function from scratch every time a person adds functionality to its Python application. Needless to say, these qualities make Python the go-to programming language for academics as well as business organizations, making it imperative for students and professionals to learn this language. With Python, one can build just about anything, from simple script to complex applications. Now let us see how we can start installing Python. One can install Python in any operating system. One can download from its official website python.org and install. Once you have installed Python, then you can start coding using Python command line. Another interesting way to write and execute Python codes is to use Ipython, which is an interactive command line terminal for Python. IPython was created by Fernando Perez in the year 2001 with an intention to support rich media and Python scripts in a single integrated container. Fernando Perez is also the co-founder of Project Jupiter and has developed the interactive computing products such as Jupiter Notebook, Jupiter Hub, and Jupiter Lab, which is the next generation version of Jupiter Notebook. During this course, we will be using Jupiter Notebook, sometimes Jupiter Lab. Jupiter is actually an indirect acronym of three programming languages, Julia, Python, and R. So what is Jupyter Notebook? It is a client-based interactive web applications that allows users to create and share codes, equations, visualizations, as well as texts. The advantage of using Jupyter Lab is that one can save the final product in various formats, such as in PDF format, in HTML format, etc. And it can either be presented on a browser or can be shared on a site such as GitHub. Jupyter Notebook and Jupyter Lab can be installed in any operating system by following steps given on its website, jupyter.org. One can also access them online from jupyter.org/try. However, it is much easier to install all these things through one of the most popular distributions of Python, which is a free and easy to install package cum environment manager known as Anaconda. So I recommend you all to install Anaconda, and once you install Anaconda, all these things will be available. So what is Anaconda? It includes actually scientific packages such as data science packages, including Jupyter Notebook, Jupyter Lab, Spider Editor, and all these things can be installed in any operating system such as Linux, Windows, and to install Anaconda, you can simply go to its website and follow the instructions from docs.anaconda.com/anaconda/install. Let me show you all these things by visiting each of these websites. So if you want to install Python, you can simply go to its website python.org and go to download, and you can download based on your operating system, whether you are using Windows or you are using Mac or you are using Linux, then you can go to source code. So for example, this is 3.8.5 window version. You can download and just double click and it will install. And once you have installed this, you can open the Python command line and then start coding. You can also look at this documentations, which provides some books, some beginner's guide, and even developer guides, etc. So actually, for learning Python, this is one of the best resources. If you want to install Jupyter, you can visit its website, jupyter.org. And if you go down, you see the first thing it shows is Jupyter Lab, which is version 2.0. And it says that it is Jupyter's next generation notebook interface. You can use this online without installing in your system, or you can install Jupyter Lab in your system. So if you just click on this, it will show you the installation steps. So you can install using Conda, or you can install using Pip. Similarly, you can install Jupyter Lab again from the jupyter.org. So if you just go down here, this is Jupyter Notebook. Again, you can use this in your browser without installing it, or you can install this by following the steps like this. So if you go to jupyter.org install.html, again you can install using this conda, or you can install using pip install. Once you have installed this, you can set it up using this command conda install -c conda forge, and you can get started. But as I said, it is much easier to install what is called Anaconda. So you just visit the website anaconda.com, and then actually it has various options. If you just click on the product, it has individual edition, which is open source and free. It also has team edition, it has professional edition, enterprise edition. So let me click on individual edition. So once you click on individual edition, if you just go down, then you can go to down, click on download. Once you click on download, it will give you option to download Windows version or Mac version or Linux version. So let me click on this Windows version. So Windows version has 32 bit and also 64 bit. So you can just download whichever is appropriate for you. So if you click on, for example, let us say 64 bit graphical installer, then it will download. Once you install, it may take little while to install. Once you install, then you can go to this open what is called Anaconda Prompt. So let me just open Anaconda Prompt. Okay. Once you have opened this Anaconda Prompt, then you can start Python just by typing command Python, and you can start programming using Python. Add two numbers, press enter, it will give you the output. You can exit this using Control D command. You can similarly start IPython by typing IPython. So this is IPython. Again, you can say multiply these two numbers, then put star in between, press enter, it will give you the output. And again, if you want to exit this, you can say Control D. It is asking you, do you really want to exit? You can press yes if you want, no other. Similarly, if you want to start Jupyter notebook, then you can say Jupyter space notebook, and then hit enter. It will start Jupyter notebook in your browser. So this is where, this is the Jupyter notebook, and you can see it gives you some of the files in this directory. And in order to get started, you can go to new and then choose Python. Click on Python, it will open Jupyter notebook, and this is where you can start coding. So we will be using the Jupyter notebook throughout this course. Let me exit this. Let us go to again Anaconda command prompt. Let us exit this by typing Control C. Once you have, you can also type, for example, spider. It will open spider editor, which is a very good editor for Python programming. It takes little bit time. Yeah, so this is Jupyter editor, and this is where you can type any codes, and then in order to execute, you can click on run or use shortcuts. So here execution is also done through IPython. That is what you see here. This is Python IPython console. Okay, let me exit this. You can also launch all these things, Jupyter or Jupyter Note, Jupyter Lab or Spider through what is called Anaconda Navigator. So if you say Anaconda, then if you type in search box Anaconda, then you see there is one Anaconda Navigator. So if you click on this and open this Anaconda Navigator, this is what you will see. So you can see here all these things are available from this navigator. You can launch Jupyter Lab, you can launch Anaconda Jupyter Notebook, you can launch Spider. It also has various other things which we may not be using. Okay? So this is another way of launching Jupyter Notebook or Spider or Jupyter Lab. So we will be actually using Jupyter Notebook throughout this course. Even Sage Math will be executed through Jupyter Notebook. So I hope all of you will be able to install Anaconda and will get started with Python. So in the next class we will start using Python from the scratch. So thank you very much, and we'll see you in the next class.